Here's the latest from Earth Now. This display shows the NOAA Climate Digest for September 2013. The Climate Digest summarizes noteworthy statistics for the month, season, and year. The average global land and ocean temperature for September tied with 2003 as the fourth warmest September since records began in 1880. During the second half of the month, as Argentina began its spring season, the country experienced significantly low temperatures, with some areas recording their latest snowfall on record. Meanwhile, the United States had its sixth warmest September since records began in 1895. Also of note, two hurricanes made landfall on Mexico's east and west coasts within 24 hours, claiming over 80 lives. Southern China also experienced a tropical system, as Typhoon Usagi made landfall on September 22nd. Australia continued its warm trend, with its warmest September on record. Also warm in September was Norway, with its sixth warmest September on record. This real-time dataset is updated monthly and shows the global land and ocean temperature anomalies. Anomalies are simply departures from average. Blue colors indicate cooler than normal temperatures, whereas red colors indicate warmer than normal temperatures. White indicates near average conditions. First, we can see the deep blue colors over Argentina, indicating below average temperatures throughout September 2013. Red portions of the map, as seen in the United States and Australia, highlight regions around the world that experienced above-average warmth. Globally, it should be noted that the six warmest Septembers on record have all occurred since 2003. This real-time dataset shows sea surface temperature anomalies measured by NOAA satellites. Blue colors indicate cooler than normal ocean temperatures, whereas red indicates warmer than normal ocean temperatures. Although ocean temperatures hovered slightly below average in the eastern tropical Pacific, NOAA's Climate Prediction Center predicts that neutral El Niño-La Niña conditions will continue into the northern hemisphere spring. At 17 straight months of neutral conditions, this marks the longest stretch of such conditions since the time between 1992 and 1994. This real-time dataset collected by microwave sensors on NOAA satellites shows snow and ice cover updated daily. Watch the progression of days and note the retreat and expansion of snowfall. The September sea ice extent for the Arctic reached its annual minimum on September 13th. It was the sixth lowest sea ice extent since records began in 1979. Finally, we'll move to Antarctica and discover that its sea ice extent reached its annual maximum on September 22nd. It was the highest sea ice extent on record. And that's your September 2013 Climate Digest. For more information, please visit the website shown at the end of this video.